Hi, I'm Henry Segerman. This is the Countdown D24 by The Dice Lab, which is me and Robert Fathauer. Countdown dice, also known as spindown dice, are not used for generating random numbers. Instead, they're for keeping track of your score or some other number in a game. In Magic the Gathering, for example, people often record how many health points they have with the number on top of a D20. You can use a standard die for this, but you'll spend a lot of time hunting around to find the next number you need. Standard countdown dice improve on this. The numbers are arranged in a spiral, making it easier to find the next one. However, there are still three choices for which way to turn from each number, and there isn't a consistent pattern for which way the path for numbers goes. Also, for some reason, on this countdown D20, the opposite numbers still add to 21, which means that 11 is on the complete opposite side from 10. Our countdown D24 solves all of these problems. The shape is designed so that there's a clear path that zigzags up and down around the die, counting from 24 down to 1 and then looping back to 24. It's very easy to roll it forwards or backwards, however many steps you need. And as you saw in the intro, if you put it on an appropriate slope, it will roll, counting down all on its own. The idea to make a better countdown die came to us from Alexandre Muñiz, who had read an article I wrote on Rolling Acrobatic Apparatus and suggested making a die based on the Sphericon. The Sphericon is made by starting with this double cone shape. You cut it in half, twist 90 degrees, and glue the two halves back together. Here's a glued version. The two cones have formed a single surface going around the whole shape, along which it smoothly rolls. So the first idea was to replace the cones in this construction with many-sided pyramids and make a polygonal version of the Sphericon. We could then put numbers on the faces and get our better countdown die. There's a problem, however. Sometimes there's no face pointing upwards, so there's no good place to put a number. Thankfully, there are other Sphericon-like shapes. Instead of starting with a shape made from two cones, we can start with one made from three cones. Again, we can cut, twist, and glue. This time, however, as it rolls, there's always smooth surface on top. So when we polygonize the shape, we always have opposite sides parallel, so we can write our numbers on them. Most of our other dice are relatively standard polyhedra, because we need all the faces to be the same so that the dice are fair. Here we don't need that requirement, and in fact we cannot make all of the faces identical. This made the design of the shape of the die much more interesting. Because of the dihedral symmetry, the number of faces had to be divisible by 6, so 20 sides wouldn't work, but we wanted at least that many so we went for 24. To find the exact shape, I used Kangaroo, which is a physics and optimization engine built into the design software I use. This evolves the shape until it takes the same amount of tipping to the side to roll it over any of the edges along the path. The red edges here are measuring these tipping distances, and it's slowly getting closer to them all being the same. The fact that the die can roll along its path was a bit lucky, we hadn't planned for it, and it's a little tricky to get it right. You want a slight slope to get it rolling, but not so much that it starts tumbling, and give it a tap to get it going. If you make the slope so steep that the die starts going on its own, then it will tumble. If the surface you're rolling on is too smooth, like a piece of paper, then the die tends to slide rather than roll. So you want something a bit grippy, like the iPad cover I've shown you already, or this three-ring binder. Even on these, the die rolls in quite different ways, slipping more on the binder while being a bit more bouncy on the iPad cover. And finally, because I know that people will want to see it, here's what it looks like rolling down a slope from below. The slope here is a thin sheet of transparent plastic, which has enough friction to get the die to roll, on top of a piece of glass, which gives some necessary stiffness. Alright then, this is the Countdown D24 by The Dice Lab. Thanks for watching.